Hey everybody, welcome to Pinoy Crossover. Kumusta kayo na lahat? We are Filipinos talking about basketball. I'm here with my co-host and we got a special guest. We got Marky Mark with the scarf right here. Nice scruff going on over there.
We're all growing it.
for Harden or something like that.
This is...
We got JR over there.
What's going on? What's going on?
And we got a special guest, James. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me, man.
So let's just dive into, you are the guest of honor. So talk about your relation to basketball. You reached out to us and we saw that you're putting out opinions about different sports. But let's talk about basketball. How did you get into basketball
and when did you fall into it? I started when I was young, basically. I played since 5 years old and stuff like that. And then when I went to middle school and high school, I played competitive high-level sports with basketball and football. But by my senior year in high school, that's when I tore my ACL and meniscus at the same time. So I was basically done. I don't know what to do. So my coach said, like, you know, start doing stats. So that's when the time I started looking at stats, how coaches coach, and how, like, analytics about sports or and stuff like people don't really talk about, like, the unknowns. Mm-hmm. You know, when you start knowing about sports, you start searching about, like, the unknowns, like when Warriors are doing bad without Curry. They were like 21-20 without Curry when he was injured, to Len Bias got like died after drafted 2 days after when he was ODing in cocaine. So something like that, you know, that's when it started. And now I, you know, guest in shows, talk about sports and like even like football and other things like that.
So. What got you into, I guess, the sport of basketball? What's something that got you really, really into it or got you really curious about the sports itself?
Yeah, well, with sports, you never know. Yeah. If you watch teleseries in Philippines or like a show in US or Canada, sometimes you can tell the ending. With sports, you never know when it comes to football, especially football, March Madness in college or other things like boxing when Manny Pacquiao got knocked out. We didn't expect that. So something what got me is basically just something new all the time. And and something having a passion with sports is you just start researching things that people didn't know and all that stuff.
What is the most recent thing that you've been trying to investigate in terms of what made you or what analytics are you looking at currently?
Well, I was a guest in ANC. So it's an ABS-CBN sports, sports and news channel. And for me, just talking about football and in Philippines, because in Philippines, like I told you guys, you can't watch football because it's 1 a.m. to 8 a.m. And then it's here for us, it's Sunday night, we can just chill, have a little beer and stuff like that. But there it's hard to watch it. So just to for you guys too, just having like a race awareness about sports in Philippines, or like for you guys, like women basketball, Filipino leagues, and so that's something new, you know. So something that I love to do.
So,
you know. Growing up, which team in the NBA or which player in the NBA did you grow up watching and just like really been a fan of?
For me, it's Allen Iverson. I remember playing NBA Live. Iverson got 99 speed.
Wow.
I remember that one.
You're looking at the numbers.
On a fast break. He's
this guy really abused the AI in the game.
99 speed with Speedy Claxton. You guys remember Speedy
Claxton? Oh, he's fast too. Really.
So it was just like since then, even though I didn't live in Philadelphia yet, I was a Sixers fan. And then next thing you know, I moved there and become a Sixers fan, Eagles fan. So for me, just Allen Iverson's killer instinct.
Describe us like the fans in the Philadelphia, because I know Philly has one of the best loyal fans. It's almost close to like the Madison Square Garden, the New York Knicks fans. Describe us like the Philly fans, because you were one of them.
So. Yeah, well, Philly fans is different. They were brotherly love. We call this brotherly love because you never know. They will cheer for you the next day, and the next day they will like hate you. And then if something happened, like a ref called something, they would. It's like church or something like they do every Sunday or something. That it's something different when it comes to it. You see it in Toronto, because in Toronto, it's the whole country. If something happened, they will be crazy mad or something.
Yeah. Exposure is like they're kind of the religion.
Exactly.
Something like Boston, too. Boston has that rich history with many of their teams.
Yeah, exactly. Because it's four sports there. Mm-hmm. Like Toronto has hockey, baseball, basketball, and they even have football in Argos. So, yeah.
Going back to Allen Iverson, was there a matchup that you loved watching, like him playing against someone?
Against a team that he...
Raptors.
Did you watch that playoff game against like the Raptors and the Philly with... Allen Iverson scored 40 and then Vince scored like 40 as well with the game.
I was still young that time, I did watch it. I did watch Iverson going through that playoffs when they played the Bucks. He was hurt, and then when he played the Raptors, and it was just something different. Like, cause Philadelphia fans, Toronto Raptors fans, you know, it's crazy, like two giants colliding. So it was something, you know. Different and something, you know.
And what are your current thoughts about the Philly team right now?
Philadelphia, I love Philadelphia. I'm just annoyed how like they keep losing to Boston. But the first
Boston,
time,
I guess they have the number. Boston has their numbers.
This is the first time actually I'm scared of Raptors.
Yeah.
Like last year, I know they will choke, or they will go through LeBron James, or like the last 2-3 years. Mm. But this is the first time I'm actually like. Scared of Raptors because of the firepower and all Kawhi Leonard and other things like that. So I'm just,
So if your team and our team goes head to head, what's your thoughts?
Best of seven.
Be honest, right now.
Okay, most of our
fans here is like the Raptors.
Yeah. I think it will say game seven. The only problem about our team is the coaching. I'm not too like. I support Brett Brown, but I'm not too sure if he can go past to the promised land. For you guys, it's just, you guys have the team. And Nick Nurse might be really, you never know. Because Nick Nurse, I see him like changing stuff. Like yesterday, Siakam, they played the 3-2 zone. Mm-hmm. When Siakam's on top, like, and then that was, I was like, oh, like I've never seen, they barely, in NBA, they barely play zones because they can, NBA players find a way to beat it. Mm-hmm. So for him to even do 3-2 zone is okay.
Yeah.
So Nick Nurse might be on something. So
so you're choosing Raptors over
there. I don't know about that. I don't know.
He hasn't fully trusted the process yet. Yeah. This year.
So like you said, I was frustrated in in the process, but it worked out a little bit. So
All right. You guys got a good team now. So.
Yeah. I'm happy.
They're not too shabby. Yeah. And Joel is an entertaining guy, and I love watching him talk to other players, right?